Well, retirement drinks with teammates turned sour for North Melbourne's Jack Ziebell after he was coward punched outside a Melbourne bar, putting him in hospital. Penelope Leash has more.
Jack Ziebell and his teammates were continuing the celebration of his retirement here at the Osborne rooftop and bar in the early hours of this morning. Around 1 a.m, the former North Melbourne captain was punched and kicked in what police say was an unprovoked attack, injuring his face and nose. It's understood he may require surgery. Outside today, a trail of blood still leading from the venue's side door onto the road. Detectives spending the morning speaking with staff and scouring the street for CCTV. In a statement, North Melbourne has confirmed Ziebell had been celebrating his final match at a club function earlier in the evening and that he exited the venue and was immediately set upon by a group of men needing to spend the night in hospital. It's understood Richmond and Collingwood stars Dustin Martin and Tom Mitchell were also part of the celebrations at the bar last night. Police are still searching for the man who attacked Ziebell and two others that he fled with. The bar's owner says it was a random attack by a thug out on the street, calling it an upsetting end to what should have been a night of celebration.
Well, with the Voice to Parliament referendum fast approaching, campaigning is now ramping up across the country in an attempt to win over undecided voters. Federal politics reporter Rhys D'Alessandro has more.
Both the yes and no campaigns are rallying supporters in the final months before the Voice vote. Today, hundreds gathered in Perth for the launch of the WA Liberals for No campaign. Speakers including Senators Michaela Cash, Karen Little and Jacinta Price. Meanwhile, the Foreign Minister Penny Wong and Voice advocate Noel Pearson took the proposal to a Sikh temple in Adelaide. It follows the Prime Minister's calls on the Labor Party faithful to join the Yes 23 campaign, one that is widely expected to outspend the no campaigns.
If you don't know, vote no. We don't need it as a country. It's not going to solve the problems for our most marginalised. There are far better ways to move forward, and that's what we're here to say.
What is there to fear? That's what I'd say to the people who are advocating. Now, what have you got to be frightened of?
Australians will focus when the last few weeks when they have to determine whether they write yes or no on their ballot papers. And if they say no, then of course more of the same will continue to exist.
The likely date for the referendum is October 14. That is now less than 8 weeks away, but both sides believe there are millions of Australians who are undecided, and both sides say volunteers on the ground will be crucial in winning over those who are unsure.
The AFL has stood down a goal umpire after a costly mistake ended Adelaide's finals chances. Let's go live now to Joshua Dorr with the latest on this. Josh, last night's result will stand.
It will, Alicia. The apology today, cold comfort for the Crows, who should still be in the finals calculations but are not anymore. And it's as a result of this Ben Keys kick. Every camera angle at the Adelaide Oval showed it clearly going through for a goal, but the goal umpire believed it hit the post, and he was so adamant that no review was called, therefore couldn't be overturned. Sydney going on to win by 1 point. That goal umpire has now been stood down for the rest of the year as a result of what the AFL is calling a human mistake. Adelaide CEO Tim Silvers fronting the media a short time ago, clearly angry and frustrated with that result. This is both he and Gillon McLachlan today.
There's a bit of anger. We're shattered. But, and also in all my days in footy in 20 years, it's probably the biggest match day error I've come across.
That was a mistake. I want to say conclusively that if the decision had been reviewed, it would have been overturned and it would have been a goal.
Perhaps unsurprisingly, Gillon McLachlan today standing by the score review technology and system. Alicia, there'll be no changes for the upcoming final series.
Okay, heartbreak for the Crows. Josh Dorr, thank you. Well, former television host Andrew O'Keefe will remain in custody until he faces court later this month after he was refused bail on a charge of breaching an apprehended violence order. The 51-year-old was arrested at a unit in Sydney's Point Piper overnight. O'Keefe responded to the magistrate's decision by saying, "Thank you, Your Honour, for nothing." Hurricane Hilary is barreling north, with Mexico's Baja Peninsula the first in line to be hit. US correspondent Lauren Tomasi has more.
This is the calm before the storm here in Southern California. We're in Orange County at Seal Beach, where residents here are preparing for the effects of Hurricane Hilary when it hits in around 24 hours' time. People have been loading up sandbags in case to protect their properties, with authorities warning there could be more than a year's worth of rain. Residents are worried. How wild is it for a storm like this to be coming?
It's super wild because we're not used to nothing like this. I mean, we get rain in the fall, like
winter.
This is the first time in Southern California's history that a tropical storm warning has been put in place. They haven't seen a system like this move through the area since the 1930s.
We will prepare for worst case scenario, not only to assist people here in our county, but if we're not impacted or affected, we will become a resource to other neighboring counties as needed.
It's been 84 years since one came ashore, so it's a once in a lifetime event that we're going to be experiencing.
Right now, Hurricane Hilary is barreling its way up along the Pacific and towards Mexico, with wind speeds reaching more than 177 kilometres per hour. There are concerns for cities like Tijuana, where there are properties teetering on cliff sides and fears of mudslides. That storm system then making its way through to California, where residents now are waiting for what's to come.
Shocking vision has captured the moment a popular pizza bar in Adelaide's eastern suburbs was set alight. The devastated business owners are now counting the cost. Beth Excel reports.
The bar closed at 11 o'clock last night. 3.5 hours later, arsonists hit, and this is now all that's left of the popular business.
Dressed in black, five hooded figures appear calm as they prepare to carry out the unthinkable. Spark lit, they flee as the flames grow. In a matter of minutes, Bar 38 is engulfed.
I just heard there was a fire, so I think it could have just been something small. Just drove past here and just seen it and nearly burst into tears.
The blaze so fierce it damaged neighbouring businesses and took 30 firefighters nearly an hour to control. The shattered owners on scene this morning to see the damage for themselves.
I'm gutted. It's a complete disaster, I would say.
Dion's sister Claudia Bonifazio is the winner of reality TV show Love Island. She talked to her social media today, calling for support for her brother, saying the restaurant's been in the family years.
It's a really good business and it was doing really well.
A stolen car found dumped and torched an hour later is being investigated as possibly linked.
The damage bill is estimated at $200,000, but in a further blow, the business owners have told us they don't have insurance.